Well, he was at the center of one of the most highly publicized political scandals in recent memory and even went to jail for it. But tonight, Julius Henson says he wants to be Baltimore City's newest state senator. 11 News reporter Lowell Melzer joins us in the studio with more on this controversial candidate. Lowell?
Yes, Dan, Julius Henson spent 30 days in jail for his connection in the now infamous robocall case, where robocalls were placed to primarily African-American districts in Baltimore City and PG County to keep those folks away from the polls during the O'Malley-Ehrlich governor's race. He now tells 11 News voters in the 45th district where he plans to run would not only forgive him, but vote for him as well.
Do you think he can win?
Absolutely. I wouldn't be doing it if I don't think I could win. I think the opposition, I think the current senator believe I can win. And obviously you must think I got a chance because you wouldn't be here.
A confident 64-year-old Julius Henson tells 11 News he is now going after Senator Nathaniel McFadden's seat in the 45th district in 2014 and is not holding back.
People in the 45th district are hurting. Most of the people don't know who their representatives are, and those that do know are not satisfied with the direction the district is going in.
Henson served 30 days in jail in 2012 for conspiracy for his role in the illegal 2010 Election Day robocall.
To let everyone know that Governor O'Malley and President Obama have been successful.
Suggesting the gubernatorial race between Governor Martin O'Malley and former Governor Bob Ehrlich was over before the polls had actually closed. Henson says voters in the 45th district will be able to look past his past.
It was a minor charge, which is under, it's in the, still in the courts, and so we'll see. But no, I think it'll be no problem whatsoever.
He's certainly a threat in East Baltimore.
Political consultant Donnie Glover agrees with Henson, admitting his conviction could be a roadblock, but not a deal breaker.
It certainly would leave a bad taste in people's mouths. At the same time, people will also have to consider 20 years of Senator McFadden, and you know, has he peaked?
I think it's going to be very hard to turn Senator McFadden out of office.
Other political consultants like Matthew Crenson feel it may be more of an uphill battle, but will definitely get Henson recognition.
This will get him back in the public eye and allow him to state his case before the public, and maybe restore his career as a political consultant.
Now, Henson tells us that his three-year probation, which he says is under appeal, prevents him from political consulting, not running for office. He plans on making his announcement official next Monday. Senator McFadden, though, declined comment for this story. We're live in the studio tonight. I'm Lowell Melzer, WBAL-TV 11 News.